How you doing? Good? Yeah. I'm doing excellent. I feel like I just busted a nut. I do. Probably because at the break I went to the bathroom to bust a nut. I do that when I get nervous sometimes. It's one of those things, you know. Oh my god, there's an exam tomorrow! I just have to do it. So, are there any English teachers in the house? Are there any real English teachers in the house?
Fuck yeah!
You know, the ones that know what the zero, first, second, third conditionals are?
Man, yeah!
Grammar. Yes, right. Well, look to your left, look to your right, English teachers, because this is your competition for jobs. I just saw who said, woo! Competition. So yeah, I'm an English teacher. I've got a funny story about the first time I had an interview out here in Barcelona. I sat down, you know, with the director of studies, and the first thing she says to me is, Robert, do you like to do adults or do you like to do kids? In groups or one-on-one? Or both? At which point I kind of thought to myself, I was like, wow, you're kind of pervy. I didn't get the job because I was thinking out loud. So. Anyways, I do that often. So I'm working at a school now and I love the place I work at. I mean, I was supposed to be working tonight, and you know, here I am. Because I called in sick.
Yeah.
I got weird. Yeah, I teach kids and adults, but not together. You know. But, you know, you do get some like really crazy students sometimes, you know? Like, I've got this 7-year-old student. He's kind of amazing and kind of 7 going on 45. You know, we were doing the verb to be in the negative form. So we were doing drills, you know? I am not a clown. I am not a car. I am not a ball. I am not American. And then we got to little Elias, 7 years old, and he's like, I am not an experiment. What the fuck? I'm not an experiment. I am not going to deal with this right now. Next student. Right? You know, like, how do you deal with that shit? And then I have this other student, you know, a little bit older, and he's like, how come, this is a real story too, he goes, how come we can say conversation, penetration, and ejaculation, but we can't say conversate, ejaculate, and penetrate? And I was like, whoa. You're going to have to wait until you're 12 to ask me that question. Wait until you're in adult class, okay? I'm not going to answer that now. But it's okay. It's a lot funnier than you guys are letting me know. Okay, so I was out with a friend the other night, and we were having dinner. He's a vegetarian. Any vegetarians in the house?
One.
I'm not a vegetarian, okay? And we were having this long, heated discussion about, you know, vegetarianism and, you know, the pros and the cons and how the pros outweigh the cons and blah, blah, blah. And I was like, well, I'm a meat eater. I like red meat, I like chicken, I like pork, I like fish. I like proteins. And he's like, tofu! Protein with flavor. Tofu with soy sauce! Whatever. And then at the end of the conversation, he's like, and it's so much healthier for you.
Preach, preach.
Speaking of health, he also told me, he goes, you know what, Robert, you're kind of like straight man slim, But you're like gay boy obese. You're like, dude. Wow. And you're just like, what are you talking about? I'm not. Gay boy obese. So I joined the gym, right? And did you guys know? Did you know this? All the gyms in this area or in this city only speak Spanish. How rude. Right? Oh my god. So I took a Zumba class, right? Because I wanted to get my Zumba on.
Oh, dang it!
Right? I was like, Zumba. And I thought it was going to be simple because Zumba is Zumba in any language, right? No.
True.
Right away, you get in there, girl starts out, she goes, vamos, empezamos! My mind is still, I'm a non-Spanish speaker, so my mind is trying to wrap around, vamos, empezamos! And by the time I translated, she was already, a la izquierda, a la derecha, derecha, arriba, abajo. And I was like, okay, girl, you're working out my mind more than you're working out my body. This is not working. So I left. It didn't work. So, speaking about health, this whole thing about health and the idea of vegetarianism all kind of started when I hit 40. Okay? I know I look like I'm just like, you know, no one day over 50.
25!
Over 30? You know, the whole idea of health came when that 40 was the mark for me. The mark when I was like, I'm getting old. But not even just mentally, because I feel great mentally, spiritually, but the physical stuff started to show up. Like, my forehead started getting bigger, my hair started thinning out, I started noticing, you know, white hairs and wrinkles, and I started thinking, God, I should have paid attention to my grandmother's advice, because she told me, she goes, if you don't want to look old, you have to use oil of olay every day, morning, noon, and night, and if you laugh, you have to laugh like this. Okay, try it, go. Right? No wrinkles. I look at myself in the mirror. Fucking amazing. But I never ever paid attention until, you know, whatever. Yeah, and then, oh my god, the worst. This happened when I was 41. When you turn, like, and it doesn't matter the age, but when you get a white pubic hair. Oh my god! I was in the shower one day and I was like, oh, I'm gonna wash this gray right out of here, you know, trying to get rid of that shit.
Thank you.
And then I looked down, and then like this beautiful black bush was like this thing that I thought was a thread. I was like, what is that? Ow! You know, and then they tell you this shit like, oh, you need to make sure that you don't pluck it, because if you pluck it, more will grow, and fuck it, it's out. No, this is not staying there. Fuck that shit. It was horrible white hair. And don't get me started on, like, getting older and the penis. The penis. Like, 40. Like, when I was a teenager, 20s, 30s, it was like boing all the time, you know, it could rain, it was like boing, no problems. When I turned 40, that shit was like, no. Not right now. I don't want it. Don't touch me, you know? And then, you know this trick, guys. Guys, you know this. When you kind of got like that semi going on and you like squeeze it at the base to make it a little harder. No, that even is like, no, I don't want to. It's like trying to pop a balloon with a marshmallow. It doesn't work, right? But one good thing happened this year. I turned 42. And I had 2 years of sobriety. Woo! Yeah! But I still drive. probably like, shit, I was driving around the town the other day, and I hit a dog. And I saw this little old lady walking around with a leash without a dog. So I asked her, I go, I'm sorry, you know, I wanted to do the right thing. I'm like, do you have a dog? She's like, sí, claro, yes, yes. And I was like, I think I just hit it. And she's like, oh, how do you know it's my dog? What does it look like? What does it look like? I was like, oh. No, cabrón, what does it look like before you hit it? Pressure for a face. Anyways, that's my time, guys. Thank you.